Dear Howard, you are one of the deepest thinkers of our time. You are a philosopher of social science and a scholar of peace and global studies. We so much thank Alicia Cabezudo, who has registered for our workshop now, for introducing you to us in 2006. Dear Howard, I have no words to thank you for including us in your lifelong journey of reflection on how a dignified future of humankind may be possible. It is an enormous privilege to have you as esteemed member in the Global Advisory Board of our community and as a core founder of our World Dignity University Initiative. Also, I personally are deeply indebted to you. You have authored the foreword for the book on dignity in solidarity that I just finalized. You have lovingly supported its coming into being in practice and with your theory building. You have taught and lectured all around the world, living in Chile and often working in South Africa, together with our dear Gavin Andersson, with whom you founded the Unbounded Academy. I had the privilege of joining you in both places, Chile and South Africa. In 2012, you kindly invited me into your intellectual universe in Chile. You generously declared your home in Chile to be one of the Dignity Dialogue homes of our Dignity community. And this was also my home for many weeks in 2012. Our dear Brian Ward, who is with us here now, he made a wonderful plaque for our Dignity Dialogue homes in 2011 in New Zealand. And I took this plaque with me all the way to you, dear Howard, in Chile in 2012. Then in 2013, you kindly joined us in our Dignity Conference in Stellenbosch in South Africa, hosted by our dear Helene Lewis, who is with us just now too, and our dear Joy Ndwandwe, who participated yesterday with us. After our conference in Stellenbosch, we worked in Pretoria for many weeks together with our dear Catherine Odora Hoppers, and your lovely granddaughter Justine did the video recording of our dialogues, and we saw something now. And now I think I stop. I will put this text on the website because I go on because I wanted to show you a little bit of the a little glimpse of Howard's brilliance, both intellectual and ethical brilliance. And especially the concept of solidarity, which is in the title of my book, and how Howard defends the use of this word. But please go to the website. I will put that text on there. I think now my time is out.
Thank you so much. Evelyn. Thank you so much. Now, Howard, we have an award for you, but we'd like to give you the floor to have a few words before we give you the award. So it's over to you, Howard.
One thing I should say is that my screen is unstable. Every now and then it sort of blanks and doesn't work. So don't be surprised if I suddenly become paralyzed and don't exist anymore. I'm really impressed by this workshop. It's just amazing that there's so many brilliant people around the world doing such good work. It's such a light in a darkening world. So I really want to congratulate all the people who are here and all the people who've made it possible. And I hope that our dear Uli won't be too discouraged, and we really will go forward with the World Dignity University. And even though it's been a long time in gestation, that we'll actually move on some of the things that were a little bit discouraging for Uli because he worked so hard and got so little response, but we'll try to make it up to Uli. And really, we say in Spanish, poner las pilas, that is going. I might mention that I've just been asked to lead a chair at the level of Latin America, which is, I believe it's accredited in both Ecuador and in Chile. So that's something I want to check out. That might be a building block for the World Dignity University, but it might be also a false alarm. What else did I want to say? Maybe I don't want to say anything more. Maybe I think I've used up my time, I'll say one more thing if I get an excuse for it. But the one more thing I want to say is this. If you study Orthodox mainstream economics, one of the things you'll learn about it is that it cannot be refuted by facts, because it's set up logically in such a way that it doesn't, all the facts have to confirm it by definition. So there's no logical way you can find evidence that it's wrong. But what you can do, and what Gavin and I did in our book that Dignity Press is publishing, Economic Theory and Community Development, we set up an alternative conceptual system, which is also true by definition. It's like the periodic table of the elements. The elements are, by definition, what the periodic table says they are. Well, we've produced a counter theory, which we call unbounded, in the sense that we're not against anybody, we want dignity for everybody, and we're calling for really an ethical upgrade, and I believe an ethical upgrade is possible. We were just talking in a small group about Kohlberg's theory, and I just wrote a memo to Evelyn recently in which I said if we could just get everybody to at least the third level of Kohlberg's development in the world, and then we could make the ethical upgrade that would make it possible to transcend economics and sort of move beyond economics to what you might call a post-economic society that still learns from, doesn't be, I mean, neoliberals aren't wrong about it. Thing. Neither are Marxists. Everybody has something to contribute.
So Howard, I think your connection is fading on us, but we have heard every single word. We might have lost Howard. So we have to give him his award soon. Here's what his award will look like, but we haven't figured out how to get it to him. It's a little heavy for mailing, but we'll catch up with Howard. Please, everyone, would you write your congratulations to Howard in the chat so we can give that to him and share that to him with him when he's back in the room? And thank you, Evelyn. Thank you, Howard, wherever you are. You're an inspiration of all of us, for all of us. Thank you for being a beacon of dignity in the world and in all of our lives, Howard. We're so glad you're with us.